Okay, so at this point, it's pretty well established that I have a lot of merch, right? Like a lot. Maybe too much for one person, a lot. I've thought about doing a full tour for a while now. Never did it because I never had all of it clean at the same time, ever. But now that Toronto is almost here and I've been actively washing a lot of stuff, pretty much all of it is clean. So I thought, let's take this opportunity. Full merch tour. Here we go. Also, someone asked for this. I think it was Fangirl Emblem. Hi, shout out to you. Here you go. I know you wanted to see this. We're gonna stick another counter there. Actually, technically not all of it. I just mean shirts, sweaters, long sleeves, like apparel, all right? I'm going location by location. So we're starting off with this drawer and we are starting off with this stack of merchandise of bands that I don't support or don't listen to anymore. Reasons why I still have this are either A, I like the design, B, I haven't gotten around to selling them yet, or C, I don't want to sell them yet because they cost me a lot of money. All right. Here we go. This is gonna take a while. First off, this Sunset Songs shirt from their 2016 Very Rarely Say Die tour. This is a little skeleton. It says Bring the Bright Lights, which is a song of theirs. And I've been told that this guy looks like he's dabbing. Then this is one of my oldest ones. This is a Five Things of Summer shirt that I got in a bundle with their first album in 2014. Next up, this One Ok Rock 27 Ambitions tour shirt. I think this is the only yellow one that I have. It's very cool. I like it a lot. Fun fact, I went to this tour instead of my school's annual Christmas ball. Then I have this one that I bought secondhand off of Vinted. This is the Five Things of Summer 3 tour tee. This is the one tour that Faisals did in Europe that I did not get to attend, which is so unfortunate because they played Melkweg Oude Zaal in Amsterdam, which is a little concert hall that holds 600 people. Then I have this Eden long sleeve from, I think, the 2018 Vertigo World Tour. It has the dates on the sleeve and then a little logo as well. Then I have this Waterparks tee from the 2022 See You in the Future Tour, I think? I'm not sure. This is a shirt that I also got secondhand at a thrift store. I found this in 2022, which was wild. It's just this Midnight Memories One Direction tee. And then there's this shirt that I have a love-hate relationship with. This is the Five Things of Summer Show World Tour tee, Amsterdam version, Amsterdam Ziggo Dome, October 1st, 2023. And of course, since Faisals decided to make special for merch for Amsterdam, it had to be fucking orange. Next up, this really old Faisals tee from Primark. I think I bought this in like 2015. It's extremely faded. It has like the second logo. I think this is the second logo, third maybe even. It's the logo that they started using when they weren't allowed to use the Tally logo anymore. Then I have this little mixed tee from the 2017 Glory Days tour. I think I should wear this more often, honestly. Halsey, Hopeless Fountain Kingdom tour, world tour tee, which it says Starcrossed World Tour on the back, which I'm curious if this tour originally was meant to be called the Starcrossed World Tour, because it ended up just being called the Hopeless Fountain Kingdom tour. What I like about this one is that it has a little butterfly down at the bottom. Then I have this Five Things of Summer Meet You There tour shirt, which is slightly misprinted. I don't know if you can see that, but the colors just didn't really come through on this one. And then it has the dates on the back. Sure, fall down, that's fine. Dates on the back, and I actually flew to Glasgow for this tour. Then I have another really old one. This is a shirt from Halsey's 2016 Badlands tour, the European version. Next up, I have this little Waterparks crop top from the Intellectual Property tour that I bought in November, last November. Very cute. Five Things of Summer tour tee. This was from their 2015 Rock Out With Your Socks Out tour. What a name that is, my god. Then I have this Avril Lavigne shirt that I bought, I think at Bershka not too long ago. I'm not sure if this was a genuine tour or not, just thought this was cute. And then we have my oldest piece of merch, and I can't believe I still own this. This is the shirt that I bought at the One Direction 2014 Where We Are tour. This was the first show that I attended ever, if we're not counting Cadry when I was a kid. This was the show that started it all. Another Faisals one. This is the limited edition Valentine's Day tee, which has Valentine lyrics on the back. I actually didn't buy this off of their website. I bought this secondhand on Vinted for €2.50. €2.50. Then I have another oldie. This is my shirt from Five Seconds of Summer's 2016 Sounds Life Feels Life tour. What makes me sad about all of these white tees is that they start yellowing really, really fast. This is the other shirt that I bought at Halsey's 2018 Hopeless Fountain Kingdom Europe tour. This is a long sleeve. This also has the dates on the sleeve. And then on the back, it has this print, which is really cool. And then on the other sleeve, it just says Hopeless Fountain Kingdom. Another white long sleeve. This is the long sleeve that I bought at the Meet You There tour. So this is a Five Sauce shirt. Really like the print on the back. And then this one says Five Sauce on the sleeve. And then just a little Five Sauce on the front as well. Next up, I have a shirt that is so much cooler than I thought it was when I originally bought it. This is a My Chemical Romance shirt that I bought when I saw them live. And I saw this and I was like, oh, cool. Castle, goth looking, wonderful. What I did not know when I purchased this is that this print is glow in the dark. I don't know why it wasn't advertised as being glow in the dark, because I think it would have sold so much better if it was, but this is glow in the dark. Bring Me the Horizon, Bear of Dead Tea. Not belonging to any tour, but bought this, think it's very pretty. Then I have this, the 1975 tea. The print is really starting to fade on this one, but I love this series of shirts that the 1975 did with the box and the song titles. And then I have one that I showed in a video not too long ago. This is the Bring Me the Horizon and cult member vest, which is part of their European merch line from this year. And then to conclude the drawer, I have this Spice Girls tee, which unfortunately has a little makeup stain on it that just won't go away. But this is really big, nice and oversized, and this is just from H&M. Then we're gonna continue with this first rack. This rack is sorted by artist, though there will be artists in here that we've already had. This is the 1975 shirt, Falling For You shirt, again with the box, black and white, solid. And then at that same tour, I also bought this, the 1975 Still At Their Very Best tour tee with the dates on the back. Then we are moving on to Good Kids. So this is the drone tee that I bought in London last year. This is very, very cute. This shirt is so fucking cute. I could not get it. And then I have the first Good Kids shirt that I bought. This is my Nomu tee that I bought when I saw them last year, pretty much a year ago. I've been trying my best to keep this print as vibrant as I can. It's Nomu. I want to keep him looking fresh forever. And then this is my favorite Good Kid shirt that I own. I bought this on clearance a few months back. It's very cute. I love this so much. So cute. So cute. I love this. Next up, we've got Bad Omens. So this is just a normal The Death of Peace of Mind tee. Has this print of the back. Very cool. And then I also have the Concrete Forever tour tee with all the dates on the back. Okay, then we're continuing with Bring Me the Horizon. Then I have this Bring Me the Horizon Stupid Medicine tee. Love the little detail with the logo on the back. Only downside to this is one, it's really long for some reason. Like, this is a size medium and it's so long. And I do sometimes feel like I look like a bit of an anti-vaxxer when I wear this, but that's not the point of the shirt. Also love that this is a ringer tee. Then I have this. This is Sempiternal 10 year anniversary long sleeve. This is such nice quality. I've gotten this really big, oversized, really, really nice. I also like the kind of stonewash on this. Unfortunately, the print on this one has faded quite a bit, but this is another Bring Me the Horizon one. This used to be a really nice saturated red, and now it's not really. It says Steel City 04. The next two I've already shown off in a recent video. This is the Bring Me the Horizon Survival Horror European Tour tee. And then this is the D-Generation Kool-Aid line long sleeve. And then this is another tee from the Survival Horror European Tour. It's this pink purpley one, really awesome print. And then on the back, it has all of the tour dates. And then we're moving on to Stand Atlantic. Both of these tees were featured in my favorite band merch video. So this is the Stat Kebab tee with the menu on the back and the Powerpuff Girls tee. Then we have this Little Mix hoodie. This has a bunch of Japanese writing on it. I know that some of it says Little Mix, some of it says Wasabi, but I don't know what is what. I don't speak Japanese. And then the back, it says Hot Wasabi, Sweet and Salty with some more Japanese writing. And then this is a little poop of wasabi. Okay, and now we're diving into Five Souls again. First off, the Summer Brothers Live in Concert shirt. I feel like this is a bit of a deep cut that I'm not gonna explain. If you know, you know. Then I have this star shirt, which just says Five Seconds of Summer in the back and the star in the front. Shane mistook this as Converse merch, so I'm not sure what that says about this tee, but I still think it's cute. Then I have this shirt, which looks really old, but it's not. I bought this from their 10 year anniversary line. So this this is a remake of an old shirt. It has the 2014 UK tour dates on the back. I didn't attend this tour. And then I have a shirt from the Faisal show, the European tour, from their world tour that they did last year. Then I have a sweater that my mum bought me. This is the Faisal's 5 sweater with the Joshua tree and everything. And then it has all of the song titles in the back. You know, when I look at all of the Faisal's merch that I have, I really do think to myself, oh my god, why do you have so much? And then I remember that I've been a fan for 10 years and I'm like, oh yeah, that makes sense. This is the Take My Hand Tour tee. Love the back. Take My Hand Tour, it has all of the dates. This is from their 2022 tour. And then this is another tee from their 10-year anniversary line. So this is a remake of the No Place Like Home Tour tee. And then I have this stunning deep blue Take My Hand Tour jumper. This is so pretty. And then I have another sweater that my mom got me for Christmas a few years ago. I think this is part of their Teeth merch line. So it says Faisal, an Australian band called Five Seconds of Summer, which is really cool and neon yellow. And then this is another one that my mom got me for Christmas. This is one of the two Youngblood hoodies. I kind of also still want the black version of this. Alas, this is the only one that I have. So it just says Youngblood on the front, then a barcode of some sort, and then it says Youngblood on the sleeve as well. Next up, we have Water Parks. This is a shirt that unfortunately has shrunk in the washing machine. This is the long sleeve that I bought when I saw them for the first time in 2020. This says Water Parks on the sleeve. And then of course, this one again, this one, you know, this one. And then I also have this sweater. This has Water Parks on one sleeve and then Funeral Grey on the other one. And then it has this Float My Way print on the back as well. Next up, Halsey. Also showed this in the other video, 2016 European Badlands tour with this on the back. I love this style of merch. I miss this style of merch so much. This is my favorite still. Has a reference to Amsterdam on the back, so what can I say? And then this long sleeve, which I imagine says Halsey on the front, and then it also says Halsey on the sleeve. It says live fast or die here with the skull on the back. I made a video about this particular long sleeve because I didn't buy this at the concert. I did go to it, did not buy this shirt. Wanted it for years and then finally found it for resale for a decent price a few years back. Charm of Halsey, I also have this Manic World Tour sweater. I can't feel a thing. It has some paint splatters on it. It has the A01 H3 on the sleeve and then all of the tour dates on the back. And then we are moving into Louis Tomlinson. This is the crop top that I bought at his 2022 tour. Unfortunately, this has some yellow stains on it and I'm not sure what they are. They just won't come out in the wash. I love the back. I'm obsessed with the back. I love that it's a crop top. And then I also have this Faith in the Future World Tour sweater. A very, very nice green color as well that I think suits me quite well. Then we're moving over to Ariana Grande. This is one of my two shirts from the Sweetener tour. So this one is the retro pink one, which has the tour dates on the back. And I really like the style of shirt as well. And then this purple gray one that has her on stage doing the little back band thing during The Light Is Coming, which also has the cities on the back. And then of course you can't be an Ariana Grande stan without owning this. So I too own the Nortus Left to Cry jumper. And then I have this lilac one, this Seven Rings one. This is just from H&M. It says Ariana Grande in the back. And then it has a little ring on the sleeve. Ooh, this one also has a stain on it. I didn't even notice that. Then we have Set It Off. I own this really fucking obnoxious rainbow tie-dye shirt from their Elsewhere tour. This also has a really sick fucking graphic on the back. I don't wear this very often, especially not out, because I just don't feel like it fits with my hair very well. But oh my god, this one is cool. Then I have this After Midnight sweater. Just has a little broken hourglass on the front. And then on the back, it says After Midnight with the hourglass and Set It Off. Unfortunately, this baby has been sun bleached. And then I also have this one. I got this one at their 2019 Midnight tour. And then we've got a couple more. We're almost there. Yeah, I don't need to say anything about this one. Then I have this 1AK Rock one. This says that it's a luxury disease tour shirt, but I got this while they were on tour with Muse. But I think this one's really cute as well. Then I have this Within Temptation shirt that's starting to really disintegrate, to say the least. And then it also says Within Temptation on the back. I bought this at Black Widow in Rotterdam, back when that was still a thing. And then I also have this The Purge tour tee from their 2022 tour that they did with Evanescence. So this says, I'm crowning no man for his armor or rhapsody. And it also says Worlds Collide Tour 2022. Then I have the Evanescence shirt that I bought at that show. I didn't think I would be buying Evanescence merch in the year 2022, but I did. Then I have the Spirit Box shirt. Bought this in January. It just has Courtney on the front and then it says Spirit Box on the back. Another one that I've already shown you. These are the Water Parks Intellectual Property booty shirts. Of course, I can't forget the one that I'm actually wearing. This is a new one. This is the main shirt that I bought on Tuesday. It has a little disco ball and then on the back it just says World Tour with the tour dates, which it's funny that it says World Tour because it just has the European dates on there, but sure, whatever. And to really end this video on a high note, we're ending with the Good Kid Mamie's Delivery Service jacket. This is a kind of khaki gray bomber jacket, which has really sick fucking details. Has a little narrow. My God, this is a sick one. And that is everything. I haven't counted it yet. I won't actually count how much I have until I edit this video, but holy fuck, that's a lot. I don't even need to know what the exact number is to know, oh shit, that's a lot of fucking merch. And I know that there will be more coming because I've got problems. I know that I'll be buying a lot of stuff at Good Kid in Toronto. So this video is only gonna be accurate for like 2 weeks, which is fun.